Hello traders, this is Umar with you and hope you had a good weekend. So off lately I've been shouting that go, don't take any positions when there is a long weekend, and see what has happened. Bank Nifty, Nifty both gapped up, and Bank Nifty, you know, because of HDFC Bank, in spite of HDFC Bank not performing today, both Nifty and Bank Nifty was able to sustain the gap up. That is a good news. But the bad news is Nifty was not able to sustain above 18,500. So 18,500 is a crucial resistance, I think. As you know, we are going into uncharted territory and we have to see what is going to happen and closely monitor the charts. Now, what I have seen is, what I am observing from the chart is, if you see it in a candlestick perspective, there is a formation of doji pattern. You know what is doji, right? Whenever there is a doji at the top and or at the bottom, there used to be some kind of reversal or correction. So I expect some correction. And if you see the Nifty, last 3 or 4 trading sessions, it is gapping up, and it is sustaining the gap ups. Let me show you. So if you see this one, this is the Bank Nifty, and I'm going to take you to Nifty. See, on 13th of October, Nifty was around 17,600, gapped up settled around 18,100, again gapped up and closed at around 18,300. Today also gapped up and settled somewhere around 18,500. But this fourth gap up is formation of doji. You have to observe here. I have marked down here whenever there is a doji pattern, markets are reversing. Here on 1st of October, there is a doji. Here there is a doji, and 7th of April there is a doji pattern, and 25th of February there is a shooting star, some kind of doji pattern. So all these things are happening whenever I see. I don't give importance to candlestick, but whenever I see a doji in the top or in the bottom, I kind of be cautious. So that's what I am trying to say. So is it the time to be cautious? I really don't know. See, because whenever, if you have been monitoring the, when, if you have been following the market, or if you have been following us ever since March 2020, market is continuously moving on the upside. All this is happening in spite of weak global cues. You know, Dow Jones for the last 6 months has been consolidating, and now it is moving on the up. We were moving on the upside without the support of Dow Jones, but US market, but now US market is also shooting up. On Friday, Dow Jones settled around 300 points on a positive note, and today, as of now, as I speak to you, it is lightly in the red. It's down by 200 points. So we have to wait and see, right, what is going to happen and what is going to be the scenario. And if you see this one, the FII futures, FIIs have been net sellers from the 1st of October till now. For the last 10 or 12 trading session, FIIs have sold for more than 2500 crores, and DIIs have sold for around 431 crores. All this is happening only by the retail people. Retail people are taking the market upside. Do you believe this? I really can't believe this. I don't know whether what is going to happen, because we retailers don't have so much of power. The power, money power, we don't have. Unlike FIIs or DIIs, one big sell-off, one big buying, you know what will happen. FIIs or DIIs, they can take the market wherever they want, right? So it is not a good idea to go against the FIIs or DIIs. Many people talk many genius things. Retailers will do that, do this bullshit, nothing. Honestly speaking, it is not what you think. You don't have to be so much pessimistic, right? So let's see what is going to happen in the market. And you know, as I told you, HDFC results came out in spite of having good results. HDFC Bank is not performing today. I think they have performed weak today. HDFC Bank was down by around 1.5%, right? Around 1.5%, 1 or 1.5%, and the only thing which was performing in Bank Nifty was PNB, right? So, and Nifty, if you see Hindalco, Infi, Techem, JSW Steel, all were performing. And if you see the Bank Nifty, let me go to Bank Nifty, sorry for that. Yeah, this is Bank Nifty, and if you see the Bank Nifty, HDFC was down by 1% and Kotak Bank was down by 0.31%. So if we had support from HDFC, Bank Nifty would have gone to higher levels. But in spite of that, both Nifty and Bank Nifty was able to sustain the up move, able to sustain the gap up, and hopefully tomorrow is a holiday, trading holiday. So Wednesday, when the markets open, if everything is good, if we are getting global support from global cues, then we should be inching up on going on the upper side, right? Now, even though I tell there is a doji pattern, that this and all, no, I don't think markets are likely to go on correction. It is going to correct, maybe it will come to 18,000, then it is going to touch all-time high only, 19,000 or 19,000. Even 20,000, maybe before December or at December we are going to touch 20,000. So that's what I think. And if you see the open interest level, this is the open interest of Bank Nifty. There is a wide around 18,500 people are writing straddles in 18,500. So smart money is writing straddles at 18,500. And if you see the Bank Nifty, 40,000 is the super resistance, so there is a quite amount of calls in 40,000. At the same time, people are writing 39,800 straddles. So, you know, tomorrow is a trading holiday and there is going to be a good amount of theta decay. So, people are very optimistic and going in taking straddles. Of course, you can do that also, but you need to know what is going to happen. If anything goes wrong, you should be able to manage your position. So that's what I'm trying to say. So everything fine as of now, everything is good, and still now Nifty has we have been around how many, we have come across I think around 15 trading session, right? We are almost half month and there are only I think 10 or maybe less than 10, I think a 10 trading session we have. So let's see what is going to happen in this only, we have crossed only 1 month, like half month. And if you see the Bank Nifty, Nifty has crossed more than moved 858 points or 4.85%, Nifty almost 5%, Nifty has moved almost 5%. Month on move, such is the amount of movement we are getting, that is the amount of volatility we are getting. So since we are talking about volatility, India VIX is also shooting up, right? So if you see today, India VIX is shooting around, it's around 17 or 18 level. So you have to remember these things, that there is a doji pattern formation in the charts. So if that doji pattern formation is there, markets are likely to reverse or markets are likely to consolidate. We are not getting, the second thing is, we are not getting any support from global cues. Global cue in the sense, you know, Dow futures, US futures and European futures, Asian futures are all flat, right? Third thing is, FII, DIIs are not supporting this move. You have to remember this. All these three points are crucial, and I will leave it to you whether you want to take a bearish position or you want to take a bullish position or you want to be non-directional, you want to be neutral, it's up to you, right? So let's see how things pan out. Hopefully everything should be fine. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.